everybody, welcome back to the channel. So today is gonna be a pretty good video. I'm just pulling back up into the shop, just wrapping a couple things up. So if you guys follow Rhino's channel, one of his subscribers graciously gifted him a Yamaha Zuma. Now the Zumas are relevant because recently I sent mine off the launch ramp, or the freestyle ramp, whatever you guys wanna call it. But apparently Chris is wanting Ryan to call me out on something. I'm not sure what it's gonna be, but in the off chance that something does happen, we're gonna make it good for you guys. So I'm gonna show you guys a couple things real quick. We are gonna take my Zuma. We're gonna give a little bit of a tune up in this video. We'll show you guys some stuff that we did. We are gonna make it a little bit more dirt worthy, and I'll show you guys what I mean by that. So I'm kinda hoping that Ryan does call me out to do like an actual race. And that's why I went ahead and put a dirt tire on the front of the Zuma, because nobody wants to see a race in a straight line on a Zuma because they're not very fast. It's not gonna be very exciting. So I'm gonna show you guys my brother and I working on this the other night, getting it put together, taking it for its first little spin. Now for the second part of the video, I brought home my wheel loader the other day, and I've been screening dirt like a mad dog, trying to get it a little bit cleaner, make it something usable. I had some stuff that just had a lot of rock in it. It's still not super clean, but it's usable for a track. So this weekend I decided to take some time. We went and pretty much bulldozed. Well, I don't have a bulldozer, but basically flattened Rhino's 110 track, or the pit bike track, whatever you want to call it. And we spent a couple hours over there working on it. I'm going to let him show you guys that footage, but I'll just show you guys me getting ready to go over there. And it was good times yesterday. We are going to keep working on that track because I'm hoping that eventually there is a big race on a pretty substantial pit bike track between the Zumas. So we're going to go ahead and end the introduction. We're going to get into the video. There might be some other stuff that I didn't talk about in the video, but hope you guys enjoy it, and let's do this. So I'm standing inside one of the bays of my shop that I had just cleaned out. I mean, it looks very nice in here. And I even built another workbench last night right here between two storage shelves so I could have a little spot to tinker on with stuff for the first gen. But yesterday I was watching one of Rhino's videos, and I think I'm about to get called out to do a race on the Zuma. So we're gonna go through the Zuma. We're gonna make sure it's running good. But we got a new tire for it, and we actually got a dirt bike tire. It's technically the wrong size. We're gonna see if it fits. We're gonna try and put that on there. So we're just gonna start working on this, get it torn apart. We got our hobo fire going so we can stay warm tonight. It's getting kind of chilly out here. So we'll get this barrel nice and hot. And come out when we get cold.
Far out, man.
Yeah. Is this thing warm?
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't even need a jacket when you're around it, huh?
Yeah, it's really warm.
It's muy warm?
No, it's okay. So I even made this little workbench last night for the first gen Cummins build. I got all this wood off of a guy that was at the dump. He pulled up next to me in line, and I saw his truck just full of lumber. And I rolled my window and I said, "Hey man, what you gonna do with that?" He said, "Throw it away." So I said, "Meet me around back." And this ended up in my truck. And I mean, with the few exception of like a couple 2x4s, the rest of the stuff was completely free. So anyways, two of the Home Depot shelves, free lumber, more Home Depot shelf. And now I got a nice little workbench. But it's gonna get repurposed because we're working on this tonight. So up on the docket first is a tube, spark plug. Well, you only need one. One spark plug. And I gotta go get the tire out of my truck. All right, so the Zuma is not your average motorcycle. It does not have like a flat skid plate. The center of balance is not really anywhere on this bike. So we're gonna try and figure out how to get it on the stand real quick. Does it sit?
Good enough.
Nice.
Just don't breathe on it.
Gonna go for a ride on the ultimate shop chair. All right, guys. So here is our Baldini. It was due for a change like forever ago. So it is a 120/90/10. So they did not have this tire in stock, and we ride it mostly in the dirt anyways. So we're going to try and see if we can get this tire to fit on there, because this bike spends the majority of its life in the dirt anyways. All right. Let's get it opened up. Here we go. Japanese, everything's probably gonna be metric. I'm guessing a 14 for the front tire. Let's see. Boom. Nailed it. Yeah, it's way smaller.
It's still not as big as your stomach, though.
Oh. Ah. I don't know that it's going to be wide enough that, like, it'll seat on the rim. We'll find out, I guess. I think this is the same size tire as, like, the rear one on the 70.
More like Shy's 50.
So if it doesn't fit on here, it's not a huge loss because the 70 kind of needs a new tire anyway. All right, spoon time.
Dinner. You need some lights up in here.
I know. I don't know if this has a tube in it.
Stab it with a knife.
Might be tubeless.
Your desk?
I am using my desk. This is the first desk project.
Pulling the stem.
Yep.
Purging the mass.
There's no tube. This is a tubeless tire. Uh-oh.
Does that make a difference?
Yeah.
Dad, I don't even want to pop this tire.
What?
Jackpot.
Yeah, look at this.
Cool, huh?
Yeah, can I show you?
Sure. Oh. You gonna wear it as a necklace?
No. But it is big and long.
I don't know, we might be able to get it on there. Do you think we should stick a tube on there?
Yeah, probably. That's a wide looking rim. Compared to what? I think the bigger question is if we can get that on there. This is gonna look funny.
So it's definitely supposed to have a tube.
What?
It's definitely supposed to have a tube, but.
Let's see what would happen.
I think we're good. The old ratchet strap.
Oh.
Hopefully. Let's see. She's trying. I think it's seated. Yeah! with the strap tucked inside there. Ooh.
Jeez.
Yowzers. Just a little bit stretched.
Gosh.
Now let's get it tucked with a gauge. All right, let's see if I can figure this back out. I think this is the speedometer cable thing.
Chop it off, that's extra weight.
Yeah, we don't need that. But it's like a wheel spacer too, so.
Now we're gonna have that muscle car stance.
Nice.
Yeah. Look, stock. It's a mama picture. She got your bike now. Orale.
Oh, what size is this other guy? Another 14. All right, well, phase one of the build done. We got our dirt tire, although it be stretched just a little bit. It's on there.
The turbo kit, though, is back ordered.
Yeah. So any future jumps coming up, I probably will be a little bit safer landing. Unless this tire just blows out because there's no tube in it and it is kind of ballooned out. But
it's got that Cholo look.
But I think we'll be good. So phase two.
How do you get to the spark plug?
We don't know. So we're going to jump into this and lift up. You got to turn the wheel or something. No. You got to turn the steering wheel all the way to the left or maybe to the right. Lift up on the seat.
Hey, a drill.
Hey, tools. Check this out.
Sweet.
Oh, this is from when the well was having issues and it
That's extra
burnt work. Up a circuit breaker. I know I could have gone twice as far off the freestyle ramp. Let's get rid of that. All right, so I got the case off. That covers the battery. I've never opened this thing up other than to put gas in it. Never had one problem with it other than this coming off when I landed. I don't even know like where the engines actually are on these things. I don't know how this works. Oh, this is gonna be super easy.
Is that where the spark plug is?
I think.
Look at it right there.
Yeah, this guy right here?
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
It's kind of a dangerous place for it. Nice. Piece of cake.
What kind of cake?
Crumb cake.
Here's a piece of cake. Piece of crumb cake.
Best, easiest service ever.
What about the oil change?
NGK.
All day.
Oh, one more thing we got an advantage. My kickstand fell off.
Weight reduction.
So, I gotta get as big of a weight reduction as I can because.
You outweigh Ryan by what?
Because I'm pretty fat. There's so much dirt in there, we need to vacuum that out. Alright, incorrect screw number two. Oh, yeah. Goldens. Boom. Alright. Next. Well, we're done for the night, but.
Time for a test spin.
Alright, let's give this thing a go. Yeah. Let's see, key on.
Get five more torques.
Turks.
Cold start. Well, light works.
Oh, yeah. It's a little bit more peppy.
Rear brake. It's like it dug in pretty good.
Yeah, there's like certain aspects of it that like I think it's worse. But when I brake, it actually brakes now instead of just like
pushing
sliding.
Forward.
So we'll see. So I just took it for a little test spin, and the front tire being a little bit smaller, I thought it would be better with the knobbies. But I think the size difference actually makes it worse. It was pretty like, it was all super squirrely all over the place. But we'll see what John thinks when he comes back right now. Do you feel the difference?
It feels more grippy. I don't know if it's worse.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah.
All right, let's get the cover plate back on. All right, well, John's going to be taking off here pretty soon, but we're going to call it a night. So John's going to get going.
He's going to take off. Thanks for your help.
It's been like 2 minutes. I got to check my Doge. Hold
on. We're going to become Doge millionaires.
It went down.
Oh, no. That's been the story of our lives today. No Lamborghinis today. But
Where Lambo?
All right. See you later. Today's like the first Saturday that I've had in a long time where I really don't have much going on. I gotta go do some work with that dump truck for just a little bit this morning, but other than that, the rest of my day is just kind of laid back. It's gonna be kind of an easy day. So I talked to my neighbor Ryan last night, and I'm gonna go screen some dirt right now, and then we're gonna go over and help him build his pit bike track. Maybe we can widen it up a little bit, so I'll probably take a couple loads of dirt over there, and then yeah, it's just gonna be a fun day, fun video. Maybe get some footage with the old drone. And we'll take it from there. Let's go. Gotta throw my burner phone in here. This is the phone that I got to temporarily get me by until I got my new note. But it fits perfectly inside the drone controller. That's pretty much all I use it for now.
See? Fits like a glove. Alright, let's see if this thing still works. It's been a while. Go fly. Boop. Alright, got the drone up in the air.
And I forgot to key the tractor. So I gotta walk back down to my place and pick it up. Alright, now I can get back to work. I didn't feel like walking all the way back up here. Did it once already. So, jump in the side-by-side. Jump in the loader, let it warm up a little bit. And we'll get some dirt going. Real quick, I gotta do some work with the animals. If you guys ever wonder what kind of woman you should marry or be with, this is the kind of woman. One that will do stuff like this. She's been out here weed whacking, and she's just awesome. She's the best. Hey, goaties.
She is super cute. Little blue eyes.
Wanna say hi? Say hi. You wanna run around? Okay, let's go. Run.
I think she's part albino. Never had a white goat with white ears. I mean, white ears. Blue eyes.
Yeah.
All the baby girls this year have white ears. All the baby boys have brown ears. Yeah, she's so cute. She's a
baby doll. All right, clean window, cleaner. Still a little dusty in here, but way better than it was. So let's get back to work. Yeah, throw a little squirt of diesel in there. It's getting kind of thirsty. Oh, I don't have my cat key. All right, let's try this again. Should be good. All right, let's get back to work. Do to do, do do, bum bum bum. Here we go. As you guys can see, I got my little sidekick with me. I met my family out on the road as I was coming back from Ryan's place. It's a fun day over there. We got a lot done on his track. Pretty much tore it down. We're gonna start from scratch. So, I just forgot. I gotta take this over to my friend's house. I gotta load it up. So, with that said, guys, thanks for watching. You do me a big solid. Like, subscribe, share with your amigos. Hit that notification button so you guys can see all the other random stuff we got going on. And I'll see you guys next time.